Horothrus has defeated us.
Should we turn back?
There is no safety for the ring in Rivendell.
Where do we go?
There is another path. The Mines Aurea. That is a name of ill omen. But in Gondor, we will have strong allies. The enemy expects that, so the ring must not go near Gondor.
I shall follow you to Moria, and upon the great underground city of Khazad-dûm.
I will go. I say to you all, beware the secrets of Moria.
I will not go, unless the foot of the whole company is against me. The ring-bearer's voice should be heard.
I do not wish to go, but I do not wish to forsake counsel of Gandalf either.
We must reach Moria, and soon.
Gandalf speaks true. Our troubles may get worse, and soon we like.
Thank you.
We have come to the west gate of Moria. Here the elven land of Holland ended.
There is a gate here.
Dwarf doors are not made to be seen when shut. Behold.
What does the writing say?
It reads, "The doors of Durin, Lord of Moria. Speak, friend, and enter."
What does it mean, "speak, friend, and enter"?
If you are a friend, speak the password to open the doors.
Do you know the word, Gandalf?
If I am allowed a bit of peace, I shall seek for the word.
Keep the beast at bay! I need more time! Anon et Helen! Oh no, that's not it!
Thank you.
Let us rest while we can. How long will it take to get through this place?
I cannot say for certain. 3 or 4 days' march, providing we don't get lost or run into trouble.
Trouble? What kind of trouble?
Orc trouble.
Moria is vast and deep. With luck, we can avoid all the orcs.
Our luck seems to be running sour of late. Perhaps you would have preferred to remain behind with that thing in the lake?
Not me, Mr. Gimli. Not that thing or those wolves. I'll take my chances in here.
The hobbits need rest, Gandalf. This seems like a sound place to camp.
I agree. This is as good a place as any nearby.
Very well, Gimli. We shall camp here, but not for long. Orcs are on the prowl.
Certain, but I think something is following us, quietly, in the dark.
Thank you. To rest. Stay away from that well, though.
Who knows what is swimming around down there, looking for a meal?
Well, you're a small catch, Sam. It would probably throw you back.
Pippin, that's not a...
good idea.
Fool of a Took. Throw yourself in next time, and we'll be done with you.
Listen, what's that sound?
It sounds like a hammer. Someone down there is sending signals.
We'll need to move on, and soon, before the orcs come.
It draws near. Soon the mines of Moria will be safely behind us.
I hope you're right.
As do I. I grow weary of this place. It is so cold and dark.
Where are we exactly, Mr. Gandalf?
I believe we're in the upper halls. Perhaps the 20th or 21st. They've been well looted and are of little interest to the orcs.
They prefer the lower levels, despite the shadow of fear that covers them.
Fear of what?
Durin's Bane. A dark creature unleashed long ago by dwarves seeking Mithril. They delve too greedily and too deep.
Enough talk of the past. It is the present that concerns me. Do we rest or move on?
I don't think we have a choice. Cave trolls!
You'll have to handle the trolls. I'll find a way to get us out of here.
For the Shire!
The book is a record of Balin's time in Moria. I fear the tidings are grim indeed. They met with early fortune, driving out a host of goblins. Then they discovered Mithril, the riches of Moria. It goes on to tell of Balin's death, an attack by orcs. Slowly but surely, the dwarves were driven back and trapped. The last lines read, "We cannot get out. The end comes." Drums. Drums in the deep. They are coming. They made their last stand here. The effort to retake Moria was valiant, but foolish. We should be moving on.
Frodo, I fear the enemy is near. I will slay the foul beasts with my axe should they attack. Let us pass through this hall and find the others on the other side.
I will do my best to offer my assistance.
The door there! It must lead into the hall. There must be a way to open it.
Frodo! This bridge needs to be crossed!
Ah!
Aloft! Another bridge to be crossed! The switch! I see it on the other side! You must get to the switch, Master Frodo, so that I may cross!
Has come. To arms, Gondor!
Go, across the bridge of Khazad-dûm. This is a foe beyond any of you. I must face the Balrog alone. I am a servant of the secret fire, wielder of the flame of Anor. You cannot pass!
Gandalf! No!
We forged on, out of the dark depths of Moria, and soon we reached the Golden Wood, Lothlorien.
I have not been here for many long years, but I remember the way to Gorosgolothan, Tree City of the Elves.
Elves!
Be at ease. I am Haldir of Lorien. I have been following you for some time. You breathe so loud I could shoot you in the dark.
Huh?
Have no fear. The Lady Galadriel is expecting you. But the dwarf is not permitted on our land.
But Elrond chose him. He's brave and faithful.
Very well. But he must travel blindfolded.
I am no spy. I will not walk blind like a prisoner. My people do not serve the enemy.
This is our law.
I will go forward free.
A plague on dwarves and their stiff necks.
Hold. We will all go blindfolded.
A merry troop of fools we shall look. I will be content if Legolas shares my blindness.
But I am an elf. I am a kinsman here.
Shall we say a plague on elves and their stiff necks? The company shall all fare alike. Bind us all, Haldir.
So be it. I shall lead you safely to Gorosgolothan, where Lord Celeborn and Lady Galadriel await you.
Gandalf the Grey set out with your company. Where is he now?
Alas, lady. Gandalf fell into shadow. He did not escape Moria.
In all the long years full of grievous tidings, these are the most evil.
When escape seemed beyond us, he saved us, and he fell.
We will hear the tale another day, for you are weary and heartsick. We will do what we can to help you, especially the one who bears the burden.
Your quest stands upon the edge of a knife. Stray even a little, and it will fail, to the ruin of all. Yet, hope remains while all the fellowship is true.
Rest, and we will not speak of the road ahead for a while.
Lothlorien. I've never seen such beauty.
Rest, and we will not speak of the road ahead for a while.
Your quest stands upon the edge of a knife. Stray even a little, and it will fail to the ruin of all.
Rest, and we will not speak of the road ahead for a while.
Your quest stands upon the edge of a knife. Stray even a little, and it will fail to the ruin of all.
I do not feel too sure of this elvish lady and her purposes.
The Lady Galadriel! It surprises me to say this, but she is fair beyond belief. Indeed, there is no one fairer in any land.
Did you try these elven delicacies? I've never tasted anything like it. Imagine spending thousands of years perfecting your recipes.
To think, Frodo, all of this, built in and upon great trees. It's marvelous, truly marvelous.
I wonder if I shall see any elf magic while we're here.
The elves sing a lament for Gandalf. I share their grief.
There is no evil in this land or its people. Unless a man brings it here himself.
Here is the mirror of Galadriel. I have brought you here to look in it, if you will.
What will we see?
Things you desire to see, and things unbidden. Things that were, are, and may yet be.
I'll have a peek. There's only stars. Wait! What? It's Ted Sandyman cutting down all our trees! I'll cut him down! Oh, devilry! They've dug a Bagshot Row! They've run off my old gaffer! I have to go to the Shire!
Would you turn from Frodo's quest?
No.
Do you wish to look now, Frodo?
I will look. I see a land in shadows, and an old man walking toward me. Gandalf? No. White robes. Saruman? There's the sea. A tall ship from the west, and a white fortress, with seven towers. Another ship, with black sails, and the emblem of a white tree. I see a great battle, and an eye, ringed with fire.
I know what you saw, for it is in my mind as well. But the enemy cannot hurt you here. This land is not preserved merely by singing or arrows. Behold, Ninya, the Ring of Adamant. A ring Sauron cannot rule unless you fail, and he gains the ring. We would be laid bare before him. Yet, if you succeed, my power will diminish, and Lothlorien will fade.
Which do you choose, lady?
My love for my people is deeper than the sea. Yet I would cast it all away rather than submit to Sauron. I wish you to destroy the ring.
I would give you the ring, if you ask for it.
You would give me the ring freely? In place of the Dark Lord, you would set up a queen. And I shall not be dark, but beautiful and terrible as the morning and the night. All shall love me and despair! No, I pass the test. I will diminish and go into the west and remain Galadriel.
Lady Galadriel, you wear one of the rings of power. When I wear the One Ring, why can't I see into your mind or the minds of others?
Because you have not tried. But I warn you not to. You would have to become far stronger and train your will to the domination of others. And then you would lose the one virtue that makes you more able to resist the ring than any of the wise and powerful. We will not speak more of it. Let us go.
The next day we said farewell to Lorien. Celeborn and Galadriel gave us boats of elven make, and we set out on the great river Anduin toward Mordor.
Has been gone for some time. I hope his scouting goes well.
It is not Aragorn that concerns me, but you. You have a difficult path ahead.
Yes. I know what I should do, but I'm afraid of doing it.
And yet, do you suffer needlessly?
I know you wish me to bear the ring to Gondor, and it seems like wisdom, except for the warning in my heart.
What warning is that?
A warning against the easy path, against the refusal of my burden. And if it must be said, against trust and the strength and truth of the big people of the world.
Our strength has long protected your little shire.
I do not doubt the valor of Gondor, but what if it is not enough?
There is still hope that Gondor will not fall.
There is no hope while the ring exists.
Yes, the ring. We can use its power for good.
All that is done with the ring turns to evil. All can be corrupted, some faster than others.
Frodo, Boromir, make ready. The orcs have built fortifications.
What would you have us do?
Wake the others and prepare to move out. Stealth may not serve us here. We may have to fight.
Think of my counsel, Frodo. It is all I ask of you.
We'll need to clear this shore in order to port it to the boats. Gimli, Legolas, Boromir, I'll need your assistance.
Come on.
Let us retrieve our boats and continue on.
This is my fault. That ringwraith mistook Sam for me. I must make amends.
No, Frodo! We must distract the creature while they rescue our comrade. Baruch Ghazad! To battle!
Thank you.
I'll hold off the orcs. Climb to the top. I'll follow when I can.
Duros to strike.
the winged steed weakens.
You should go now, Frodo, while you have the chance.
I won't abandon you to the Nazgul.
Aye, on guard, it returns.
The Fellowship of the Ring has triumphed. They have brought low the flying Ringwraith. They have taken Frodo in safety to the very edge of Morgdor. So the Fellowship has succeeded. Yet I see the Ringbearer alone as he crosses into the Dark Land. Yet, not all alone.